think of the Supremes, you think of one of those doo-wop, Motown, R&B, blues. I mean, the Supremes to me were that, you know, one of Motown greats of all time since 1959. I mean, Diana Ross at the time, you know, she and her rest of Supremes really rose to fame. But if you look at it, it was always Diana Ross was always, you know, head above everybody. But, you know, Mary Wilson of Supremes, she was, you know, she gained worldwide re-rated as a founding member of Supreme, a successful Motown icon in 1960s, and the best charted female group in the U.S. chart history, as well as the best selling girl groups of all time. True, I reached number one in the Hot 100, with all of their singles, 10 of them featured with some backing vocals. Most of the main group following the departures of original members, Lauren Graham and Diana Ross, and 7 throughout the trio of the span. Was the only departure rate in 7. She also became a New York Times best-selling author in back 1986 and was inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. But some people say, would you ever think Mary Wilson was the driving force because she was a founding member? Yeah, but definitely Diana Ross was, like, you know, the head of Supremes, but, you know, but definitely think Mary Wilson was, you know, one of those artists that, in my mind, you know, Diana Ross was head and shoulders above everybody, but, you know, this is just me talking, but I don't think Mary Wilson ever gotten the recognition, you know. She always felt like she was, like, you know, kind of always being second fiddle. You know, I'm not taking anything away from the career, the legacy of Mary Wilson, but it was quite shocking to hear somebody like her